And we all know when we buy a new driver that sometimes it comes in a box. Normally these aren't particularly exciting, but with the Cobra King Limited, I thought I'd show you this box. Now this isn't the box I don't think you would get if you bought it, it's more a PR one they gave to us, but it kind of illustrates some of the messages that they're trying to get across to this driver. On the front it says here, put a little space between you and the competition, and space is a theme that this comes back to quite a lot. And when you open this, it kind of looks like something you'd be sent if you were a secret agent in the field and you're about to assassinate somebody. So I've got to go through each of the parts of the driver as I can build it up, and so pay attention, 007. Now we're going to start at the top. What we've got here is the head. Now what they've done with this head is make it a lot lighter. They've used a new material called Textreme carbon fiber in the head and the crown, which is 20% lighter than normal carbon fiber, so it does make it quite light, and that enables them to save some weight to move into the sole of the club. Now when you say move in the sole of the club, you think there should be quite a lot of soil. There's actually quite a big hole here, and this is what they're calling the spaceport, so you can see where the space theme is coming from. Now what this is this sort of orange disc which screws into the sole of the club. It weighs about 16 grams, and what that does is to get the center of gravity a bit lower in the sole to get the alignment of the center of gravity more in a neutral position. Now we're rather getting too technical here. If you draw a line perpendicular to the face going back through the back of the club, that is your neutral axis of the center of gravity, and the ideal is to get the center of gravity on that line as close to the back of the club as you can to get the optimum launch. So it's quite easy to get on that point near the front of the club, it's a little bit harder to get it on the back, and various manufacturers have it at different points along that line and different points above that line, not many have it below. So Cobra say that this is the first time they've been able to get it on the line, and really that is where this weight is coming in. It doesn't actually feel particularly heavy. Now the face is made out of forged 811 titanium, which is lighter than normal titanium, so again that is another weight saving, and it features the same E9 technology which Cobra have used in the past, and that is really to, if you imagine a grid of 9 dots 3x3, they want it to be the same or as fast the ball speed on those outer 3 points as it is in the middle. And inside you can see how they do that, because what you have is a slightly thicker section in the middle because the center of the face is pretty much at the limit as it is, so they have to dampen it down a touch, but then it's a bit thinner towards the edges, and that's how those off-center hits maintain the ball speed and hopefully keep you that extra distance. So putting it all together, you just screw the spaceport cover into the sole of the club. You can do most of it with your fingers. There is a little widget to help you use the wrench if you so wish, but I've got strong fingers, so I'm just going to do it this way. And then I'm going to remove the nice shaft here. It's an Adela Rogue 95, 60 grams for this particular one. It's a nice dark color, and this is a good shaft. It's in a lot of manufacturers' drivers, get a lot of traction on tour, so this is very good. And when you put it in, you've got a choice of quite a lot of lofts. So I've got the standard model here. It goes from 9 through 9.5, 10.5, 11.5 up to 12 degrees, and there's also 3 jaw settings at 9.5, 10.5 and 11.5. When you put it into the hosel of the club, you've got the little MyFly window where you can have a look and see what loft you have selected, which is quite a useful thing because a lot of the time it's quite hard to tell once you've put the club in what loft you're on. And then you use your wrench from your kit and screw it in. Now obviously when you change the loft sometimes you're actually changing the line. Cobra for quite a few models now have got the smart pad sole. So this is a raised section of the sole, just sits a little bit back from the face, and it really effectively allows the club head to pivot so that it keeps the face square to at address to suit your eye whilst changing the loft at the same time. So now I've got my golf ball launching device ready, let's take it down to the range and see how it performs. Now the first thing you notice when you put it down at address is the very sort of dark looks. I mean normally Cobra has got quite coloured heads, but this is an all black head with an all black shaft and an all black face as well. So a lot of drivers these days try to contrast the face and the crown in order to help with alignment, but Cobra don't do that, and some people will prefer that sort of sleeker look. It kind of all blends in together for me, but you know it depends how you prefer it. So let's see how it goes. First thing you notice when you swing it, it's actually quite a light club, and you know, all the technology they've put into the head does make it feel quite light, and the Adela Rogue 95 shaft is it's a little lighter than some of the other Adela Rogue shafts I've tried, and I quite like that actually. I kind of like my drivers not to be too heavy, so it does feel you can get a lot of power into the club. I think the other thing you notice is the sound. I really like the sound. It's not too loud. Sometimes Cobra drivers in the past have been quite loud. But this one is quite solid, actually. You know, a lot of these drivers use carbon in the crown. They've had to work quite hard to get the sound right, but I think it sounds very good, particularly sort of compared to an all titanium driver. Now, the big thing about this, of course, is that you've got the spaceport to really get the CG in the right place. And, you know, compared to other premium drivers, this doesn't have an awful lot of adjustability. You've got the adjustable hosel here to control the loft, but outside of that, everything sort of seems to be in position because they've just tried to engineer the head as well as they can, which, you know, is good in a lot of ways. Sometimes I think that the premium drivers with the adjustability is whether people actually need that. But you've got a premium driver which doesn't have that, and it's really up to you whether you think, you know, that's extra technology that's built in is worth it for you. Now, I've had a go earlier on TrackMan here just to get some numbers on it, and the driver is quite a sort of medium spinning driver. Maybe the flight is slightly on the high side, and really that's probably because the shaft helps it get it there. The CG's in the right position is too. So, you know, if you need help getting up in the air, then this is going to be a good driver for that. If you're feeling it's going a wee bit high, or you've got a higher swing speed, then maybe the Pro version will come in handy, because that's got a slightly smaller head, so it's going to spin a little bit less. And also it's got different lofts on the sleeve. That adjustable hosel goes from 7 to 10 degrees, whereas the one here on the standard version goes from 9 up to 12 degrees. So you only buy one head in the range, and then you use the adjustable hosel to get the loft that's right for you. And with the smart pad sole, which is that raised section, kind of pivots on it just to give you that good address position. So whichever loft you're choosing, you're getting a face which I think looks pretty square at address. Well, that's how it sounds overall with the spaceport. And I've had a little bit of fun with this. I'm going to take the spaceport out and let me see what you think of the sound of that. So here we are, we're going into the unknown. We've taken the spaceport out. Now, let me tell you, there's some fairly interesting results. Well, I don't know if you can pick that up, but you get a little sort of whistle on the way back as the air goes past that hole, and then on the way down, a bit of sort of a woof sound as it goes through impact. I'll give it one more go here. Well, I have actually took on TrackMan as well with the spaceport open, and the performance was actually exactly the same. So, you know, if you like a slightly louder sound, then you've got the option of taking the spaceport out, or you can leave it back in and you will still get very similar performance indeed. In terms of the overall, I think this is a good quality driver from Cobra. You are going to pay a little bit extra for it, but you are paying for the extra materials in here. You know, you've got the Techstream carbon crown, and you've got the different lighter titanium in the face. Outside of that, you know, the design of the face is what they've used before, the smart pan sole, they've used it before, same with the hosel. So it's tried and trusted stuff, and it all works very well indeed. And if you like that sort of darker look, the more sort of stealthy feel to it, and a lighter feel as well, then the Cobra King LTT driver is definitely one to check out. That's all for me today. So for more reviews on all Cobra equipment, please visit the website at golfalot.com.